ऑन ऑफ। अच्छा সুপ্রিয় দর্শক মন্ডলী, আমন্ত্রণ জানাচ্ছি ডক্টর টিভি চক্ষু বিষয়ক নিয়মিত অনুষ্ঠান দৃষ্টি জানালে। দৃষ্টি জানাল আর 26তম পর্বে আমি আছি ডক্টর মমিনুল ইসলাম। আজকে আমরা যে বিষয়টি নিয়ে কথা বলবো সেটি হচ্ছে করোনা লকডাউন ইম্প্যাক্ট অন আই ডিজিজেস। আজকে আমাদের সাথে দুইজন অতিথি আছেন, একজন আমাদের ইন্ডিয়া থেকে, একজন অতিথি হায়দ্রাবাদ ইন্ডিয়া, এন্ড অ্যানাদার ইজ ডক্টর তারিক রেজা আলী, অ্যাসোসিয়েট প্রফেসর রেটিনা ডিপার্টমেন্ট বঙ্গবন্ধু শেখ মুজিব মেডিকেল বিশ্ববিদ্যালয় ইউনিভার্সিটি। স্যার, হাউ আর ইউ স্যার? গুড আফটারনুন স্যার।
Yeah, good evening, good afternoon to you. Yes, I'm fine. Thank you very much.
So thank you, sir, for giving us time for our Dr. Net at TV, sir. And today we'll discuss about corona lockdown impact on eye disease.
Sure.
Okay. Dear audience, if you want to ask any question, you can just write on the comment section. We'll give you answer from here. And let's start. My first question to Dr. Raja Narayanan, sir. Can you tell me, sir, what are the general eye symptoms which should a patient alert during this corona time, sir?
Yes. So thank you very much for having me in your program. The main symptoms which should alert any patient and should make them alert to call a doctor or visit a doctor is any blurring of vision. That is extremely important. You should never ignore it, especially if it is associated with any pain or redness or any wavy lines. And if you have any diabetes or old age, so you have to immediately call the doctor or go to any clinic nearby eye doctor. Symptoms which can be waited in terms of a few days or weeks is like if you have any watering, you have any itching or any burning sensation. These not associated with any blurring of vision, you can generally wait or even have a teleconsult with your doctor. Your doctor may be able to see your photo or video and can prescribe medicines over the phone or WhatsApp. But any blurring of vision with or without pain or redness, you should immediately consult a doctor.
Dr. Tariq, sir, can you add something, sir, on regarding this?
No, what Dr. Raja has told, that is okay, that is very, very nice. But actually, we wanted to know from Dr. Raja Narayanan that how many patients with COVID positive patients they have got in their OPD or in their during this lockdown time, how many patients they have seen there in Hyderabad?
Yeah, so that's a very good question. So if you see how can COVID patients have any eye problem, that's the first question we should all understand. So COVID patients, coronavirus, can have conjunctivitis. In fact, that's the only disease which has been seen in the eye, although there are some reports that it may cause some retinitis kind of picture or even the aqueous or vitreous humor some patients may have. But your patient will not have any symptoms, but conjunctivitis can be a presenting symptom. But that has been shown to be in less than 1% of COVID patients. So it is extremely rare even for conjunctivitis if you have any coronavirus. Actually, in L.V. Prasad Institute, what we have is we have not been allowed to test for any COVID unless the patient has any respiratory symptoms and fever for which the patient has to be referred to a government hospital. So at this point of time, I would say we are seeing general conjunctivitis, but they don't have any history of fever or any cough or breathlessness. So we are not having any such patients who are coronavirus suspect at this time. But if you have any patient with conjunctivitis, you must always be alert to COVID.
Sir, what are the dangers that you think regarding this eye disease during this time for the patient?
In terms of non-COVID, they are like patients whoever has past history of diabetes or whoever has received any injections earlier for macular degeneration, or patients who have sudden vision loss with floaters, which can be a signal of bleeding. Patients may be having diabetic retinopathy. So these are the danger signs which patients should be looking for. Someone who has been known to have cataract, has already shown to a cataract specialist earlier, and they have said that you can wait, then those patients can wait even now. There is no urgency to get a cataract surgery done, especially if you are in a COVID hot zone or a red zone. You should not venture out unnecessarily, especially for symptoms like cataract.
Sir, can you add something?
I don't want to add. I want to hear from Dr. Rajanarayanan that how they are actually dealing with their patients, so we can help our patients here. In Bangladesh, you see so many general eye specialists. They have their own practice. They have their government set up, and they have their institutes also. As you see in LB Prasad Eye Institute, so many patients are coming, only eye patients are coming. But in my hospital, Bangabandhu Sheikh Mujib Medical University, this is a multidisciplinary hospital. So many patients are coming with fever, with cough, and we are sharing the same OPD, and orthopedics department, gynecology department, medicine department, pediatrics department, and eye department, all are in the same flow. So how can you triage the patients with conjunctivitis or without conjunctivitis? It is very difficult for us. So can you advise us when we will start in future, within 2 weeks time, we have to start in full scale, how we can start in near future?
Yeah, so again, a very good question, but it's a very important question because you don't want to be affected by coronavirus yourself and you don't want to be transmitting to others because of crowding. Well, LB Prasad Institute usually is known for very high volume like your hospitals there, and we also have crowding in terms of patients, a lot of patients coming in the waiting area. But what we did, a major change was that we stopped taking patients or seeing patients the way we used to see earlier. There is no crowding, patients have to come by appointment, and we have made boxes where patients can maintain distance while waiting in a queue. The middle seats of the waiting areas, where usually they are in triplets, there are buckets of three seats, the middle ones have been removed now. So there is a big gap between two seats now. And also in the reception counter where there is billing or check-in process, there is a safe distance between the reception staff, and there is one row of chairs for patients to sit and do the check-in process or billing. And behind that, there is another row of chairs maintained at about 3 feet, 4 feet distance, where the second row of patients can sit. So at any point of time, if we were seeing earlier 10 patients per hour to 12 patients per hour, we are strictly restricted it to 5 patients per hour. No patient can enter the building. In fact, the security gate is closed. So the security does not allow any patient inside unless they have an appointment. They also check their temperature with an infrared gun, and even the attendant whoever is accompanying the patient, they are also checked, ask these questions, do you have any symptoms, only then allowed to enter. And there is a triage desk where our fellow doctors are staffing it, and if a patient has only urgent kind of problems, they are allowing the patient inside. So we are very strict about who is coming, entering the building itself, and through both security as well as our triage doctors.
Thank you, sir. My next question to you, that is, you tell me that conjunctivitis is one of the signs of COVID-19. How can we differentiate? You know, how can a patient can differentiate that it is conjunctivitis due to COVID or another?
Yeah, at this point of time, there is no specific sign based on which you can tell that this is because of COVID, this conjunctivitis. If you have a patient of conjunctivitis, all you need to ask is, do you have any symptoms of fever, cough, breathlessness, or have you been in contact with anyone who has had COVID? If there is any such contact history, then you must be very careful in examining these patients. So whenever you have such patients, be prepared, because you never know before examining whether a patient has COVID or not. There are a lot of asymptomatic patients also who don't have conjunctivitis. So you must, like we have normally an N95 mask, we wear a visor, and we wear gloves while examining patients, and you use Johnson buds to elevate the lids. Between the slit lamp and the doctor, there has to be a shield. So all these are now 100% universal precautions which we have taken. So there is no way you can differentiate this person has COVID or this person does not have. You have to assume every patient has COVID and you take universal precautions. That's the only way you have. And then we have other precautions, like we have frequent hand washing, sterilium sanitizer at every place. The patients are given the sanitizer when they are entering through the gate into the hospital, and also open door. In terms of clinics, normally you have a door and the patient walks in, and the door is closed once the patient is inside. But now the door is always open, even when the patient is inside and the doctor is examining, so that there is no need to open the door by touching the door.
Dear viewers, we are talking with two guests, our respected guests. That is one, Dr. Raja Narayanan. He's the director of Subban Clinical Research Center and consultant retina vitreous of L.B. Prasad Eye Institute in Hyderabad, India. And another is Dr. Tariq Reza Ali, Associate Professor, Vitreo-Retina Department and Bangabandhu Sheikh Medical Mujib Bishwavidyalay. And if you want to ask any question in the comment section, if you can, we just feel free to write question that our sir will give answer from here. My next question to Raja Narayan sir, can you tell me, sir, just I think I have a patient that is I'm a cataract patient. What should I do in this situation? Should I come to hospital or not? And what should I do?
Yeah, so cataract patient generally should not come out if you are in a COVID hot zone. So if your area is not a hot zone, let's say it's a green zone and there is no crowding in the hospital, you can always schedule an appointment with your doctor. So what we have made along with All India Ophthalmology Society and the Vitreo-Retina Society of India, the guidelines, while we have made all these assumptions and restrictions, who can go to a hospital, but we have also made it clear that if you are in a green zone and your hospital is not crowded, you are free to take care of any surgery. So if your hospital is not crowded, you don't have too many appointments, and your patient has cataract and you are in a green zone, you are free to do the cataract operation of this patient as you would normally do. But if you are in a red zone and your hospital doesn't have appointments, there is no harm in delaying the cataract surgery by a few weeks or even a few months. But if a patient is anxious and patient doesn't know how long they can wait, or they are afraid that the cataract may progress, they are always advised to call up their doctor, have a teleconsult. So in this time, what has changed a lot during COVID is that doctors have become more available on telephone. So teleconsults have become extremely important in our country. And a lot of medical cases are not being taken care of by teleconsult, including prescriptions for dry eyes or glaucoma, refill of prescription. All these things have been solved by teleconsult. The patients who are being encouraged to come to the hospital are those cases who need any urgent operation like retinal detachment or any such disease where we cannot diagnose over the phone. Those are the patients who are being asked to come to the hospital.
If any patient wants to do cataract surgery, is there any precaution should take from a doctor? What precaution should take from a doctor and from the hospital?
Yeah, so again, it's a very important question, both from the doctor's point of view and the patient's point of view of how comfortable they are coming to a hospital. From the patient's perspective, there is not much of a change that they have to do, except that every patient should wear a mask when they are going out of the house. Always remember that you should wear a mask when you step out of the house, especially when you go to the hospital. And you, when you go to the operation theater also, as a patient, you should be wearing the mask. Other than that, in India at least, we have an app which can have contact tracing of patients by way of Bluetooth if someone else is nearby who is having coronavirus. That is a useful app for us. But other than that, it's mostly the hospitals and doctors who have to take precautions that don't call all patients in the morning or at one particular point of time. You spread out patient appointments. If you were doing 3 cataract surgeries per hour, calling 3 patients per hour earlier, now call only 1 patient per hour. The waiting area should not be crowded. And in between your cataract cases, you must give 15-20 minutes for the air out and cleaning of the operation theater. And whenever you are doing an operation, wear an N95 mask for ophthalmologists. Although there are now a lot of WhatsApp videos in circulation about aerosol formation during fake emulsification, but it's a closed chamber. I don't think it's a problem. But the bigger concern is general anesthesia, in fact, rather than fake emulsification or vitrectomy. So doctors need to be careful to wear an N95 mask and preferably wear a goggle like I have one here. This, if you can wear these fully covered glasses during cataract surgery, and it's easy to do with microscope. This doesn't create any problem during microscope surgery. Or you can wear a visor if you are doing some orbit or oculoplasty surgery to cover yourself. We also wear a proper gown, a non-wettable gown like normally we wear for HIV patients. Those gowns are what we wear. And definitely gloves. In terms of COVID testing, it's very, very debatable, and we are not recommending COVID testing in all patients. We are assuming all patients are as if they were positive to take universal precautions.
Dr. Tarak sir, can you add something?
Yeah, Dr. Rajanaran told, actually we did everything, as you know, that Ophthalmological Society of Bangladesh also have procured one that is a protocol how to deal with the patients in this corona period. And we took help from this All India Institute of All India Ophthalmic Society and other ophthalmic societies. We also discussed with other ophthalmic societies and we managed one protocol for all of us. Bluetooth, that app, which is not available in our part of the world. Actually, I heard about these things that in Australia, they have one app that you can designate these people had COVID positive or he might be positive right now also. That is not probably available in our country. So may I ask Dr. Rajanaran, and can you tell about something? Because we have some, that is journalists also with us in this program, they can know about this, that how we can incorporate this app in our country also.
So developing the app is not a difficult process. It's easy. The only thing is it has to gain momentum. In the initial stages, when only 10% of people or 20% of people are using, it will not be able to detect many patients who may have actually come in contact with someone COVID positive. But you have to give it time. Builds up. So the government of India had built this app 1 month ago. There were very few users initially, but now there are so many millions of users who have downloaded this app. And once it reaches a critical point of, let's say, about 70 to 80%, it becomes a very useful app. It's like a herd immunity that you can have. So more and more people who have smartphones, if they download this app, and it's easy to develop this app, but it takes time, maybe a month or so, when this becomes very useful.
Okay, sir. If any patient need to change his glasses, or if any patient want to use contact lens, what is the suggestion for them now?
Yeah, at this point of time, there are good research papers that contact lens is not a problem. You can wear your contact lenses even at this time. Except that if you have conjunctivitis symptoms due to any reason, whether it's infectious or non-infectious, you should avoid contact lenses. In fact, we at L.V. Prasad Institute have now started prescribing contact lenses, and we are doing trials of contact lenses on a regular basis for routine patients who are is coming. But as I said, if you are in a red zone and if your hospital is congested, you should avoid at this point of time going in for contact lens consults. If you can carry on for a few more weeks with your old contacts or your glasses, whatever spectacles you were wearing, it would be preferable to continue wearing those and avoid congesting hospitals.
Lots of general people watching this program also. For this reason, I want to ask another question. That is, can you tell me, can coronavirus transmitted by conjunctiva for that general people?
Yes. So if someone has conjunctivitis and if someone touches the door handle or the staircase railing and then someone else touches it, it's possible to transfer. it's important that someone who has conjunctivitis, like for any other conjunctivitis, we should take care that we should not be touching or sharing clothes or towels with others, and we should always wash our hands if we ever touch our eyes. And that's why we always have to take precaution in the hospital also. Doctors who are there, they should wear gloves and always have hand wash or use sterilium or any other sanitizer very frequently, especially if you have examined any patient. After, in between every patient, you must wash your hands.
Dr. Tarek sir, can you tell something?
Yeah, you know, what Dr. Raja told, actually, this is all you all know that how this disease transmits from one patient to another. We have to be very much cautious about this. Actually, my thinking to ask Dr. Rajan Arunan that is because we are running a very extraordinary time. What I told, what I should mention, that you see, after 2 weeks, when this our lockdown period or when our this leave period will be over, we will get so many patients from other parts of the country. So many patients will be coming, and as you know, like LB Prasad Institute, we will not be able to do what we did earlier in our previous time. How we could see our patients, how we could do our surgeries, now we will not be able to do in that way. So what is your thinking, Dr. Rajan Arunan, that after this lockdown period, what will be your program? How will you start in near future, in next 2 to 3 months or next 1 year even?
No, so we have already started seeing patients like post-lockdown. So the only problem is that the transport, trains and airlines have not yet started. Our patients are less. But we have made a strict template of appointment system. Only 5 to 6 patients per hour can be seen. But then in terms of examination protocol, there are some changes in terms of what the optometrist of the initial workup is done. So the optometrist no longer duplicates the work. So they don't do the slit lamp examination because the doctor consultant themselves are going to do the slit lamp examination. So the important point is that we are trying to cut down on the overall process time for every patient. So every patient, if you can see in faster time, then you can see more patients in this per hour, or you can have decongested OPDs. So refraction is extremely limited. It's no longer a routine thing that we do as refraction. Only patients who actually have 1 month post-op, which may be rare at this time, or someone who complains that they have lost their glasses or glasses are broken, those are the cases where we are doing refraction. But routine follow-up of diabetic retinopathy, macular degeneration, conjunctivitis, we're not doing refraction at this point of time. Even intraocular pressure, it's again a very, very tricky process where a lot of people are not comfortable doing contact refraction, explanation, tonometry. So we are not doing in every patient, but patients who have history of glaucoma are on medications, there is a suspicion of glaucoma, those are the cases we are doing, checking the intraocular pressure. So these are things which are increasing the throughput time, meaning the time taken for seeing one patient has reduced significantly. In fact, I am doing home dilation for my macular degeneration and diabetic retinopathy patients who are in short follow-up. I don't have to ask them to come and then dilate. I just ask them to put drops, dilating drops, just before they leave home. Then I have seen patients within 10 minutes, they're out. So it's unheard of for a retina patient to be out of the hospital in 10 minutes. But we have had that. So these are some of the ways in which you can increase your efficiency.
Yeah, early June, we have to start in that way. But my main concern is actually, you see, LB Prasad Institute or Islami Eye Hospital in Dhaka, or National Institute of Ophthalmology in Bangladesh, they are only eye hospital. I am concerned about the government hospitals in different districts of Bangladesh or in the different divisions, their general hospital. There is a lot of patients will be coming. And one eye doctor, how will we help that doctor? This is my concern. Can you help in that way?
Yes, so even the general physicians who are seeing patients, they also have to take precautions, and I'm sure they would have taken precautions. They also cannot see hundreds of patients in an hour. So they also would be using social distancing and letting in only a limited number of patients per hour and not let them crowd the waiting areas. So whatever protocols they have followed, that will help the ophthalmologist also in terms of reducing the number of patients per hour. So I don't think that ophthalmologists themselves have to take a lot of strict action. If it's in a general hospital, every department, the general administration of the entire hospital has to take those decisions and implement those distancing policies and also letting in a limited number of patients per hour. That will help the ophthalmology department also. So overall, I feel that in fact, general physicians are also worried about their risk when they come in contact with someone fever and cough. So they are also restricting and taking extra precautions.
Yeah, so I got my answer, and I want to let our people, our patients know from through Dr. Moveen and his television that you see the scenario after the lockdown or after the our leave is over will not be similar what was previously. So we have to be very much cautious that your every patient can bear the corona positive patient. Every patient might be like that. So you have to deal the every person like that. So we will not be see every patient what we used to see previously. That should be kept in our patient's mind whenever they will come to the hospital in future. That is my great concern, and that will help our doctors. That will also help our community how to deal the patients in next 2 years. Probably we have to bear corona with us.
One question from one doctor, Dr. Sabina Rahmatullah. She is asking that what precaution to do during laser, because she is a vitreoretinal surgeon and you also a vitreoretinal surgeon. So she is asking that what should precaution.
Yeah, very good question. Yeah, I mean, it's an excellent question because a lot of us had this concern about coronavirus transmission through the conjunctiva, and the laser is a long procedure, especially if you have to do PRP laser for PDR. So what we have done is the Vitreoretinal Society, along with AIS, we have made some guidelines about laser, which includes that if it's a PRP, then it's better to do an LIO procedure with a 20 diopter lens so that you don't have to make any contact lens procedure. Patients should wear a mask. That is extremely important. But then if at all you have to do any contact laser, let's say for a very close PRP that you have to come very close to the arcade, those are cases because CSR in diabetic macular edema, we are not recommending at this time. It can be delayed. But if it's already delayed, you want to do something, putting a drop of betadine, which we normally do for intravitreal injection, that kills coronavirus. That's been very well proven in studies done more than 2 years ago. So you put a drop of betadine before you put the contact lens for the laser and also after the procedure. And if you want to clean the lenses, 0.5% hypochlorite solution is what is recommended for about 15 minutes that you have to keep. So these are the steps which can help prevent the spread of coronavirus during laser. So for PRP, Dr. Rajan, 20 lens. Yes. And if
can
it's...
Can you hear me?
Yeah. Can you
yes,
hear
yes.
me?
Yeah, yeah.
Yes, yes.
Sorry.
Yeah, so if you are doing PRP, use 20D lens, and if you are doing any contact procedure, put betadine drops before and after the laser.
If any patient, the diabetic, think that I'm a diabetic patient, what should I do? That should I come in the hospital in this situation? And what is the suggestion for the diabetic patient who are suffering for diabetes retinopathy from home?
Yes, so it's very important that diabetic patients, especially those whose sugars are not under good control, patients have HbA1c more than 8%, or if you have sugars which are more than 200, it's best to avoid any regular hospital visits. If your diabetic retinopathy had been stable, please consult your doctor over the phone. They may be able to advise you whether to come now or not, because we have seen patients now unlasered diabetic retinopathy in proliferative stage. They come with bleeding. So it's something which we cannot take lightly. But diabetic patients who otherwise have been doing a regular checkup who had been having only mild to moderate diabetic retinopathy, they can always delay their checkup by a few weeks or few months. But those who had proliferative diabetic retinopathy, especially they just had laser or were advised laser, it's best to call up your doctor and schedule an appointment so the treatment can be started at the earliest. But if you are a diabetic patient, never you have had eye screening, there was no diabetic retinopathy, and you are worried about cataract or some watering, just stay at home. Don't come to the hospital. You can just have a teleconsult and solve it over the phone.
And some patient that is complaining that sudden loss of vision, and like hypertensive patient, diabetes patient, sudden, what should they do? If there is some vitreous hemorrhage like this type of condition, should we go for surgery at this moment?
Yeah, it's best for the doctor to decide at this time, but the patient should have immediate consultation with the doctor. Make sure that the diagnosis is right. Make sure that there's no retinal detachment. It's just hemorrhage. We have had patients now who come with diabetic retinopathy with vitreous hemorrhage, but the usual protocol even otherwise before COVID was that we never used to operate immediately unless there was any associated retinal detachment. So if there is any associated retinal detachment, we do take up these patients on an emergency basis. But with all precautions, because we as retina specialists are always asked to handle we have open globe injuries, scleral tear, corneal tear, and endophthalmitis. We are taking care of patients. But if it's just a simple vitreous hemorrhage, then they can be deferred at this point of time.
What is the precaution should take in the operation theater? What is the SOP should the operation theater should take a management from the in a hospital?
Yes, so we have made elaborate program changes to the SOPs in terms of crowding, the scheduling, the number of surgeries, number of patients you call at one time is now very limited. Patients must wear a mask. And at this time, even the technicians, our nurses, circulating nurses, sterilization technicians, they all wear a visor, they all wear a full gown, and they all wear gloves all the time. And they also wear N95 masks in the operation theater. During the operation, what we do is we switch off the positive pressure ventilation at this time, which many times is with the same switch for the air conditioning also, especially during intubation. And the time between the surgeries, there's a slight delay. If you have been doing a very rapid turnaround for surgery, then it's time that you wait till you clean up properly before after the first surgery and take up the second surgery. So overall, there can be delays expected during surgery. It's not the same speed with which you can do.
Dr. Alexa, can you tell?
Another question to Dr. Rajanarayanan. Sir, as I know that in LV Prasad Institute, the OPD, they have one central air condition, and you advise to switch off the air condition. How you can manage this? Because you have centrally air conditioned system in your OPD. What is your advice?
Yeah, in our OPD areas, if you have open ventilation and it's comfortable, it's best to not have the AC and have an open ventilation. But there are places if you don't have an open ventilation, you probably need an air conditioning. But at least what you can do is keep the door open and not keep it closed. At least let the corridor air come and have some ventilation. So OPD is relatively easy. OR is difficult. You can't have you can't switch off the air conditioning in the OR. But during intubation and extubation, we stop the positive air pressure inside the OR.
What is the negative impact in the health sector in the present time we are facing that, and in future we'll be facing? What is the negative impact for this corona?
At this time, it's very difficult to assess.
Health sector.
Yeah, so the travel restrictions are there. It's not easy for patients to travel. So what I have encouraged is that more doctors should be seeing patients in the district level or not crowd in the cities. This is an opportunity that if you go to the remote areas where earlier patients were less, now you'll find more patients there. A lot of people have migrated back to their villages. and this is the time where all doctors should be actually taking care of patients in the district and village level. The number of patients who are coming to the cities from remote areas is going to be less. In terms of economic impact, if you ask, there's not much change at this point of time. We don't know what will happen in a month or two in countries like Bangladesh and India, because there are a lot of poor patients, daily wagers who don't have too much of savings. We don't know at this time, after a month or two, what will be the impact. But at this time, it doesn't look like there is a major impact. The price of cataract surgeries, the consumables, it's all the same, and patients are still accepting surgeries at the same price which was being offered earlier. One thing which can happen now is less of globalization, less of imported products, and more of locally made Asian products which are lower in price. That can be used more, and that will probably help in reducing the cost of all surgeries, including cataract. So I think they will get a lot of boost at this point of time. Doctors would like to buy less expensive equipment and consumables.
We already 30 minutes finished that. So we have little time. So my last two questions before to both of you. What is the how the person can take care of his eyes from his home without going outside in the lockdown situation? So Dr. Rajastha, then Dr. Tariq Sabila.
Yeah, so that's again a very good question. That the being problem which is happening is even school children are having online classes, and a lot of people are not going out or working, are spending a lot of time on computers, laptops, Netflix movies, or even TV channels. So it's very important that you don't get addicted to them, laptops and TVs. Take a break every hour. You should have a 15-minute break and not watch continuously on TV and laptop. Even if there is a restriction, go out to work, you may always have some possibility of taking a walk or a stroll around your house or in a park if that's possible or allowed. You should spend adequate time, maybe an hour or so every day, walking out in the open. That also relaxes your eyes.
Dr. Tariq, sir.
Yeah, just what Dr. Raja has told, I just can add something that now the patients, that is the babies, are coming with so many trauma and others, is because they are in the house all the time. They are playing, and sometimes they are getting injured with penetrating injury, with blunt injury, everything they are getting. So this should be, the parents should be very much cautious, as because children are at home. So that is one point. Another point, Dr. Rajanarayanan told that not to use the television, computers and others for a long time. And in between, you can take that is 20, 20, 21 formula. We always tell that after 20 minutes, you can have a break of 20 seconds. That is one. And you can wash whenever you are washing it, your hands, as because we have asked everybody to wash their hands frequently, they can give some splashes of water in their eyes also in that time. And who are using some eye drops, like dry eye drops, they can use that eye drops frequently, especially the aged patients. They can use their eye drops also.
Thank you, sir, for to both of you giving giving us time for Dr. TV, and we get a lot of information from both of you, especially Dr. Rajanarayanan, sir. And you know, I am giving you thank you again from your busy schedule. And next time we will again invite you for our program, inshallah. And Dr. Tariq Bridges, sir. And we want to conclude our program from now. And thank you all from our side. Actually, Darshok, apnaderke onek dhonnobad etokkhon dhore dhorje shohokore amader program er sathe thakar jonno. Amader amader ghore boshe sacheton hote hobe ebong basha theke ber howa jabe na. এবং আমাদের হসপিটালগুলোতে যেসব রোগীরা আসছেন তাদেরকে অনেক প্রোটেকশন নিয়ে আসতে হবে, এবং আপনাদের যেসব সমস্যা আছে, যেমন যেসব পেশেন্ট ডায়াবেটিস ভুগছেন, যারা তাদের ডায়াবেটিস কন্ট্রোল করতে হবে, এবং যারা আর্লি ডায়াবেটিস রেটিনোপ্যাথি এই ধরনের রোগে ভুগছেন, তারা ফোনে ডক্টরদের সাথে যোগাযোগ করে একটা অ্যাপয়েন্টমেন্ট নিয়ে তাদের সাথে যোগাযোগ করবেন, এবং খুবই সামান্য সমস্যা নিয়ে হসপিটালে না আসার জন্য আপাতত অনুরোধ করা হচ্ছে। এবং আপনারা ভালো থাকুন, সুস্থ থাকুন, এটা নিয়ে আমাদের সবসময় চেষ্টা এবং এই জন্য আমরা এই অনুষ্ঠানগুলো নিয়মিত করছি, কারণ আপনারা যেন চোখের চিকিৎসা সম্পর্কে এবং জানতে পারেন এবং ঘরে বসে কিভাবে চোখের চিকিৎসা করা যাবে এবং কিভাবে সেবা নেওয়া যাবে এটা নিয়ে আমাদের আমাদের মেইন উদ্যোগ। এবং আপনারা ঘরে বসে যে সবাই ডিভাইস ইউজ করছেন, অনেকক্ষণ ধরে ট্যাব ইউজ করছেন, এই সম্পর্কে আপনাদের আরো সচেতন হতে হবে। আপনারা ভালো থাকুন, সুস্থ থাকুন, আমরা আগামী প্রোগ্রামে আবার নতুন কোনো বিষয় নিয়ে আপনাদের সামনে আসবো। থ্যাংক ইউ এভরিওয়ান, থ্যাংকস আ লট, আসসালামু আলাইকুম।